Good morning, students of class 10. Welcome back to the online classes now. Let us continue our lesson in history. So, the age of industrialization. In our previous class, we have studied about the industrialization in European countries, especially Britain, and what were its effects towards the people and the peasants. The life of the workers, we have learned. How it had, the industrialization had effect, industrialization has an effect towards the common people and as a whole, the peasants, town areas, merchants and the world market. Now today we'll talk about of the same, the age of industrialization in the colonies. And we'll take the example of India. So 3.1, the age of Indian textiles. So we'll talk about the trade, the manufacturing process and the trade first. Then comes later on the textile mills or the industries, before industries. In our previous class also, we have learned about proto-industrialization. Similarly, in India also, before the industrial setup, production was done in the countryside, in the villages. So, it's quite similar. Now, we'll talk about this. Before the age of machine industries, before industries were set up in India, silk, cotton clothes, cotton goods, silk goods from India dominated the world market or international market. Indian clothes, Indian textiles were famous and very much popular around the world. The Indian textiles dominated the international market because coarser means low quality cotton. Coarser cottons were produced in many countries. Many countries they grew cotton, but it was not of good quality. Therefore, their clothes were also not of good quality. So, but the finer varieties of cotton often came from India. Finer varieties of cotton products, cotton clothes, cotton textiles, because in India, farmers grew fine quality of cotton. Indian cotton were of finest quality and consequently the clothes produced were also very fine, good quality. So coarser quality, low quality, coarser cottons produced in many countries, but the finer varieties often came from India. That's why Indian textiles dominated the world market. And it was very much popular. Number 3, trade with other countries. Merchants, they used to trade with other countries. Trade with other countries were done through land routes, through northwest frontier, that is Jammu Kashmir, Pakistan, Punjab. The merchant used to cross the Himalayas through passes and reach Silk Route. And from there, they used to go towards European countries. The famous Silk Route, it was connected through small pathways from the passes. And Indian merchants, they used to cross this northwest frontier through Himalayan passes. And they used to trade goods with European countries and other countries of the West. And through sea routes, merchants, they used to trade goods with other countries through sea routes from Hooghly, Surat, Chennai, Mumbai. These were the ports, big ports. From ports, Indian goods traveled all around the world. It sailed, the ships sailed throughout the world. And the goods were sent, Indian goods. So the trade was done through land routes as well as sea routes. Indian merchants, businessmen, Indian merchants and bankers, we have learned about bankers, were involved in this network of trade, of export. Import and export trade was done by Indian merchants, and along with the Indian merchants, bankers also used to get involved. They used to supply money to the traders in foreign countries. Because foreign countries, the foreign banks never allowed the money to the Indian merchants. So the Indian bankers, that was their business, to supply money. So now merchants supply advances to the villagers. Just like proto-industrialization in European countries, in India also, the merchants supply raw materials and advance money. The villagers were given advance money to produce cloth, cotton cloth. The weavers, they used to weave cloth and handed over the product, finished product, to the merchants. The merchants, they used to pack everything, all the finished products, and they used to carry it to the seaport. Merchants supply advance money to the villagers to produce cloth and carry those finished product to the ports for exports. By 1750, this network of trade, export, you can say, this network controlled by Indian merchants gradually breaking down, was gradually breaking down. So by 1750, the network of export of Indian goods, which were controlled by Indian merchants, was slowly breaking down. It was due to the machine-made goods of the Western world. It was taken over by European companies. The network of export of Indian textiles, silk cloth, cotton cloth, finer quality of Indian goods, clothes, were taken over by European companies. They were also interested in exporting Indian goods to European countries because they wanted to earn more money. As there was a great demand of Indian textiles all over the world, the Europeans also joined this trade. And the European companies were taking over slowly in this network of exports. So by 1750, this network was breaking down slowly, which was controlled by Indian merchants. It was taken over by European companies. So now in our next class, we will continue our lesson. So this much for today. And go through this properly every day. Do not miss your classes. That's all for today. Thank you for watching the video.